पर जस्ट वन मिनट, लेट मी फिंगर वंस अगेन. So this is a string format as I was explaining you. And if you want to try, you can also try it for other element also.
I know about this.
Yeah. Have you done work on this another way of using the for loop? This one?
Yeah, I know this foreign groups.
Okay. So I'm adding a comment. I will going to share this with you in the GitHub. Has sir shared with you any GitHub ID for this code?
He shared me his GitHub, that hack with a limited.
Okay. So I will going to upload it the same this file. You can practice it from there. I'm adding comment
I
also.
don't think you need to, because I know this syntax, I know it very well.
Okay. Actually, I have added this for loop and if condition because the another ma'am she who joined, I think she joined newly this batch, so she is not much aware about this condition. I think in Python, how to declare a condition and looping. So that's why I've given this short brief
I
answer.
was a beginner as well, just that I had some previous knowledge.
Yeah, great. Why she is not joining? So, ma'am, it is clear to you? Am audible?
He hasn't joined.
She joined, I think. Okay, she joined now, right? Is it clear to you, ma'am?
Yes.
Okay. So I'm just showing you with other data. So you can just understand, like, once I change this data, this number variable, which is a temporary variable, will going to be assigned with a new data, and the number of data, the count of data. So this will, this for loop will run how many time here? As you can see here, in this range function, we were running around 100 of time. As I said you, when we use 1 to 101, it will going to run from 1 to n minus 1, that is 100 times. So this I is your temporary variable, which is running 100 times based on this range. So I've just replaced this with this syntax. Okay, there's not much difference in this. This number is same, again, your temporary variable. And in place of range, I have passed this list variable, which is again acting as a range for this temporary variable. And it's telling that you have to go through this element. You need to go through this element of the list and the count. So based on that, I have explained you. So you can use this either this for loop, or you can use like that also for number is equal to zero. And that condition also you can use it. So let me run it and show you for other data. So see that for same, okay. In place of zero, if you want to check it for other 15, and let me make it 10, because if I use zero, then obviously error will come. So let's see. So for a particular 15, see, it is giving you, oops, 15, okay, let me take it. So hope it is clear to you, right, ma'am? Is it clear? Everything right, how the flow is working. So let's see about the same thing. I have added a comment also. I will going to share this code with you so you can run on your system and you can get an idea from it. Make a modification on this and you will come to know how it is working. It is easy only. You have to just declare variable and then for loop and then condition. So as this condition is become true, once this condition become true, then you will going to skip this condition for this particular condition. Okay, you will going to skip this for this particular condition when number become 15. Now for break condition. So as I said you in a break, as I said you in the break, that once the condition become true, you will break immediately out of the loop. Means you exit the loop immediately from that. So here same thing is there, but the thing is that here, once the condition true, it will not going to check it for further element. Now here same thing we are doing here. Now you can check it, like once this value becomes zero, it will immediately break the flow and it will come to this part. Okay, let me take this and show you. So here you can see this. So here in this case, once this condition becomes zero, now here the flow will be same for number in numbers, means again, this number will be going to initialize with six time, means it will going to run this for loop almost six, means six time only. This for loop will going to run six time. And this will going to check the condition here. If the particular variable, if this temporary variable number value will become equal to zero, it will break the loop. And once it will get the break, it will come to this position. Okay. In previously, when we were working with the continue, in the continue part, what they are doing? They are just keeping that particular value of the number and they are performing this operation. This operation they were doing. But in the case of break, it will immediately exit out of the loop. You can check it here. when it will come, okay, for the first element, starting from the first element of the list, for three in a number. So it will going to check, is three is present in the list, correct? It will come inside, it will going to print, this element is three. Now it will going to check, is number equal to three? No. So it will come, it will not come inside, it will work here, 100 divided by 3, and it will going to print it. Similarly, it happened for 5 and 7. Now let's come to 0. Now for number in numbers, if 0 is present in the list, condition true, they will going to come and print, the element is 0. Now they will going to check, is the number value, is this number variable, is value that is currently having this value 0, is 0 is equal to 0? Correct, condition is true, 0 is equal to 0. So they will come inside, they will print it in this format. Oops, 0 divisor, clean your data first. Okay, so they will going to print it. And now they will going to print this and they will immediately exit the loop. Now once they will exit out of the loop, they will come here and they will print this done part. Now the thing is that they will not going to operate this part and they will not going to check for further data also. Why? Because break condition will immediately break it. Is it clear to you?
Yes.
Okay. So this is the example of break and continue. Why we use break and continue? In order to meet certain condition, when we want to skip any value, then we use continue. And break is used when we want to exit in certain condition. Suppose infinite loop. Sometime, suppose you have a condition, I'm giving you an example, like an infinite loop where it will keep on printing. It will not stop. So if you use break there and certain conditions satisfy, it will break the loop. So break is used in that place. Break is used when you don't want to consider certain value or when you want to break immediately when certain conditions satisfy, and continue skipping a value, as we have seen this example. Let's see some more example. Now, I wanted to show you in case when you want to use both. Suppose if you want to use both continue and break, then how it will work. So this is again a similar example. I have declared two variables here, sentinel and dividend. And here I will going to ask the user to input an integer. I will going to input this sentinel value. Prompt one variable I have taken here. And again, this f percentage is a string format. Okay, this is not much difficult. You can change this program based on your requirement. I'm just giving you different scenario how you can use it. If you don't want to go for such complex, you can follow this explanation also. Make this simple program for score in a range. If score is equal to 49, break it. And like that also, you can make a simple program if you feel difficulty in order to get the concept. But here I am just giving you a different example so that you can modify this example and you can come out with more understanding on this. So here I have what I'm doing here. I am using both break and continue here. And here it is asking me to miss. Here I'm saying the code that please input an integer. And that input will be the value, this sentinel. Let me run this. Now here, it is please input an integer. So here, if you input any value here, now suppose if you enter -1 here and press enter, so it will exit it. It means that if you enter -1 here, it will immediately exit you. So here, this sentinel value, I pass it from here, and that's why I use it this string format, because I wanted to consider in my single quote this value. Now how the flow will work? While true, why I have added true here, so that true means always, true means one, means it means that condition will always be true. So if you do not add any condition here and you just write true here, it means that this condition will always be true. So true means so true means always be true, means the condition will always be true. Now here, once it is true, you will come inside, you will ask the user to enter a value. Okay, here how you accept the value from the user, you know, right, man? I think Tejas, you know, right?
Yeah, I know.
Ma'am, are you aware about it, like how to accept the input from the user?
Yeah.
Okay, so here, because the value that I wanted to accept from the user is of an integer type, so that's why I have written int, then in parenthesis I have written input. So this input will going to prompt the user, means this input will going to ask the user to enter a number. And once whatever number user enter, it will going to print it. In case if the number is zero, you will going to skip that. And if the number is equal to -1, you will going to break it. Let me run once again. Take another value 6. So see, when I enter 6, so when I enter 6, it is asking me if you want to do again. Let me exit it and explain you. So I have entered 6. So once I enter 6, this condition doesn't satisfy because number current value is not equal to 0. So it will not going to skip. Does number is equal to sentinel, means sentinel value is -1. No, right? So it will come to this part. It will going to divide 100 by 6 and it will going to print it. And again, the flow will go to this true part, condition true. And it will going to perform an operation. Is it clear to you? Please have a look on this code, and if you have any question, please ask me. Anything that
so
is
how
not.
How can someone get better with the logic? So I do have some understanding of looping, but every time I try to approach a problem on my own, I struggle with the logic. Do I make sense? For a beginner, how can someone get better at this?
And there is only one thing, like logic can be like improve, or logic you can build it when you will going to work more on this program. When you work on a different kind of question, then you will able to come to the logic. Like here, see, when any person, they explain you anything, or when they give a demo, or suppose when they make a program. So suppose if I give you this only, so this might be give you one logic, like if this score will become 49, then you will going to continue it. But you will come to know only one logic. But how this variety of logic you will or how different kind of logic you will come to know based on the practicing more code. And based on, there are some books are also available, like that you can refer it. Competitive programming is there. In competitive programming, once you work on competitive programming, there you will come to know different kind of logics, how you can solve this. I have those PDF. If you want, I will share with you. They are actually, they will pick one problem and they solve it. So if you go through this those question, you will come to know the different kind of logic to solve any problem.
Who's the author of this book? The one you mentioned.
It's a foreign author's. I don't remember the author name exactly. Indian author is also there, Kurumanchi. That Kurumanchi is there, algorithm data structure. he explain it. So based on that, the logic you will come to know. When you see the different kind of programs, that will help you to make a logic. Now see, I have shown you this, as I have given you example, I have shown you this program, this student score, I for loop, how I will, how you can print it, right? So you come to know like how this, there are three different way that you can use continue and break. But when I've shown this program to you, this three program, you some more logic you got it, like how I can make the program more interesting with this string format, how I can use both break and continue together, and how I can ask the user an input. So when you will practice more on this question, you will come to know about different logic. So this is, there is only one way that you have to run more code, you have to more practice on that, so that will help you to make a logic. So suppose if you run on few programs, then after that you don't need to look for the further programs. Means it will help you to build a logic, so you can build logic from your own only. Now suppose I will give you one scenario here in place of this. If I give you one scenario, if I want to skip a value, if score is equal to 49.50, how will going to make a change here? Then the logic is that, like suppose if you have might done work on that, or if you have practiced more code, you can do like this also. If score equal to 49 and score equal to 50. This condition also you can apply it, right? So based on that understanding of the different kind of logic, you can able to make a logic from your own. You just need to have a basic knowledge of the operator and the syntax of for loop, while loop, do while loop, if else, nested if. Am I clear, ma'am?
Yes. So by tonight, would you please send me the link you were talking about?
Yeah, I will going to share with you. In the fellow, I will send it to you both. So
okay.
There is actually the competitive programming platform is there. For example, let me show you one thing. It is a lead code. I take a Java class also. So there, this programming is there. There is one problem, two sum. What is this two sum? Let me show you. Okay, I need to sign in. Okay, so the problem was, ma'am, this was a solution, and let me show you the problem. This code I have written in Java, but anything we can do. See, they have given you one scenario that you need to take an array whose the name of that array is num. And are you aware about array?
A little bit.
Yeah. So in the array, you have a set of element, and you need to decide one target. Suppose user decide any target variable whose value 9. Then in that array, you need to check which element when you combine it, you will get equal to 9, and you need to build a logic, and you need to write down the indices for that. Indices in the sense, in this particular array, in which indices this element is present. So in array, indices start from 0, right? So 0 is 2 and 7 is 1. So they have given you the output 0, 1. Similarly here, the target is 6. So which two element when you add in an array, you will get indices, you will get the sum equal to 6. So it is your 1 and 2. So it is output 1 and 2, right? So this was the problem. Okay, they have given you this question. And what was the solution of that? Let me show you the...
I can tell the solution.
Yeah, please. Can you tell?
I think we have we could use double for loops here, like nested for loops. Like in Python, we could use the range part. And then we would see, like in the first for loop, we would give a range and we would get the starting value as 1. So the range will start from 1 until the end of the list and the length of the end of the list. And the second for loop inside it, it will start from 2. So we can always add index, or we could start from 0 and 1. So we could always add the first index and the next index. So, and then we could check it. I think that would work.
Yes, correct. Here, as you said, I also done in that way only. So ma'am, as you can see here, I know it's looking somewhat complex to you, but this is actually in Java. But when you are going to see the books for these problems, different kind of problem, you will able to come the logic from your own. So what I apply the logic here, I was taken the nested for loop, and starting from that I was checking is, and the logic that I applied here, that this array num array that I have taken is the value of the second element, okay, is the value of the second indices is equal to target minus num I or what. So now here you can see this, what was the target our 9, right? And suppose let me start from here, I is equal to 0, is 0 is num dot length, num is what, num is a array which is having 4 element, right? If you remember here, it is having 4 element. So length function will give you the number of element in an array. Okay, so here I 0, I is less than num dot length. So num dot length will be going to replace by 4, because in that num array we having a 4 element. So now you're going to check it, is I is less than 4, condition true. You will initialize this j with I plus 1. What is the I current I value? 0. 0 plus 1 means j value will become 1. Is 1 is less than num dot length? Num dot length is again 4, condition true. So once this condition true, you will come inside. Now num 1, what is the value of that num 1? If you can check it, num 1 is equal to 7, right? In an array, the index 1, num 1 is 7, right? Is it equal to, yeah, sorry. Yes, please.
No, I agreed. I said yes. Yeah.
So is it equal to target minus num I? What is the current value of target? 9. And num I is what? I value is what currently? 0, right? Because you come inside. So 0 value is what here? Is your 2, right? Num 0 is 2. So is it like this? Is this condition? Is it like this? You can just see this. Num j, that is your num 1, which is having 7, is 7 is equal to target is 9 minus num I, that is your num 0, that is what, 2. So then you will going to check it, is 7 is equal to 7, is this condition is true or what? The condition is true. Then you will going to return indices I and j. So I is what currently here? 0. And j is what? 0 plus 1. So you can see here the solution also, 0 and 1. And you can see num 0 is 2 and this is your 7, right? So this is kind of thing you need to apply the logic here. And this logic will come when you will solve more number of questions. So this lead code is one platform where you can do this solution, you can practice it. Any language you can select it. If you select Python 3, you need to build the same logic inside this function. You just need to write down this function, and when you're going to submit it at the back end, you will get the solution. Let me show you the how it works in this platform. This is your code. Okay, so let me copy my code. And I will going to paste it here.
So will I also find the problems here? The problems will be given here, and I just have to attempt the solution. Okay.
Yes. Problems are given here, and you can go through those problems, and you can find it out. The means how you can solve it. You can go through the complete description. They will give you the example also. What actually you need to have an input, what output you needed, how you can solve this. If you are unable to solve it, you can take a reference from the Google. You can search in the Google what approach we need to follow. You need to follow it.
Okay.
So here, when you need to run the code, once you run this code, if your code is correct, it will going to show you, okay, it is giving me an error. That compilation error. I think I am missing some curly brace. Let me add curly brace again and rerun this. So see, it is showing me it is accepted. Your input was true. Now once I submit it, it will going to show me the final result. Like what was my performance on this particular code. So you can see this, it is accepted. 49 milliseconds was taken to run your code in the server. When I click the submit button, this was the percentage. I was faster than other submission. How much memory they occupied in the main server? What was the efficiency of my code? So this is the thing, and you can get a several question, not only this one. Almost 1,000 of codes are there. 1,000 of problems are there. And once you solve this, you can see this. Lot of questions are there. And almost 39. So when I click on this 39, it will go around 2000, right? So this all will help you to build a logic. So
hope it is. Yeah, this is helpful.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks. Welcome. I will going to share you this PDF. I need to check whether it is available in Python, because I have explained, I take a classes in Java, other batch, so I have explained in Java this one. I will see if Python is also the solution available. I will upload it in the Trello. So okay. It will be helpful.
Can you try to send the solution?
Yeah, I will, by night I will send it to you.
No, I'm telling, I'll try to send it.
Yeah, okay. So this is the break and continue. I will going to share this code also in the GitHub. You can run this code and have a look on that. Now there is one more concept that we are left with. That is a pass statement. So this pass statement, why we use it? This pass statement do nothing, but it is used when your program is syntactically correct, but you don't want to perform any action. Now suppose you write this while true, this condition you write down, but you don't want to add anything, like you don't want to add any print function, you don't want to print anything, then in that case, you just need to write this pass. This pass keyword will going to make your code validate, will make your code run successfully, because you don't have any syntactically error, but you need something that make your code to be run successfully, right? So you just need to add this pass function. So as it is written here, you can see pass statement does nothing, but it is used when the statement requires syntactically correct and program require no action. Means when you don't want to do any action, but you just want that your code should be run successfully. Because if you do not add anything, then your compiler will think that your code is incomplete. So in order to tell the compiler, no, my syntax is correct, it is complete only. I don't want to do any operation. I just want to run this line only. You need to run this. You can write like this also. Okay, let me take another condition. So see here, as I added pass, right? I don't want to print anything here. So I just added pass here. So it is not given any error, right? So same thing we use it here. We use this pass statement when we just want to run the code without having any error. So when you use this pass, it will tell compiler that you don't want to do any operation and your code is syntactically correct. Am I clear? Is it clear to you?
Yes.
Okay. So, ma'am, if you have any question, then please ask. So, I think it is enough for today, and I will going to upload the video of today's class in the channel from where you can get it. I hope it is clear to you, right? Stages and ma'am, like what is continue, break, and this example will give you an idea. If you want to make more modification, you can do it, and I will check for the solution of this challenges. I will share it on the Trello, and Tejas, if you have, then you can also share it, so it will help to ma'am also to practice on that. Am I clear?
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am. So we can we will meet in the next session with more stuff. So today we have done this break and continue and pass statement. In the next class, we will do some more Python stuff with more example. And please follow this link, docpython.org, for more deep details. And this is a actual genuine resource, so always follow this document.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Yeah. Okay, so